Bon après-midi. Aujourd'hui, je voudrais vous présenter Martha Stuckey, qui est de l'école internationale franco-américaine à San Francisco, et que j'ai invitée pour qu'elle nous parle des 4 pièces de théâtre qu'elle va bientôt présenter en avril, au début avril, à l'école franco-américaine. Welcome to the French-American television, Martha.
Thank you, Aline.
And I invited you today. Could you please tell us what you are presenting and when?
Yes, on the weekend of April 3rd, 4th, and 5th, we're presenting 4 plays in French and in English.
Yes.
At the French-American School.
Okay, so we'll be in location will be the French-American School.
Yes.
Okay, and to get more information, I guess the people would call the school, and the tickets are sold at the door, right?
Yes.
Okay, so now that we took care of the details, can you tell us when is the play going to take place, the exact dates and time?
On the 3rd is opening night, which is Friday,
yes.
And that performance is at 8 o'clock. We have
right.
2 performances, a matinee and an evening performance on Saturday.
Yes.
And at 6 o'clock, an early evening performance on Sunday.
6 o'clock, so it's a little earlier, so people get home early. Can you explain to us what Bacados mean? Because I didn't pick it up myself
Certainly.
The first time.
Bacado is the name of our advanced theater ensemble, all high school students. This year we have 12 students, and the reason we call it Bacado is because it's half English and half French, and so it means back to back or dos à dos.
Okay, so do means in French,
yes,
the back.
The back.
So
and it means that we do plays in French and English back to back.
I see. Okay. Well, back to back mean
one after the other.
One after the other. Okay. So could you please describe me the first play?
Certainly. We do 2 plays in English.
Okay.
One is called Vigils by Rainer Maria Rilke, a German author who wrote the play directly after the First World War.
Okay.
It's a very interesting play because it's set almost entirely in the dark. There's one moment of light when okay. a candle is lit, and that's all.
Oh, so you cannot see too much the faces
of
the... No,
it's mostly sound.
It's mostly sound.
It's okay. very interesting because...
Okay. I never saw something like that.
No, it's a very interesting play.
It's going to be something very different.
Yes. The second play in English is To Bobolink for Her Spirit, a play by William Ng, the writer of Picnic and Come Back Little Sheba.
Mm-hmm.
It's an American play set in the 40s, and it's about a number of autograph hunters standing outside an important club, the 21 Club in New York, and waiting for a movie star to come out.
Okay,
it's
so
quite
they
short.
They're trying to collect autographs.
Right.
Okay.
Very comic,
and there are some lovely American types.
Scenes.
In that play,
okay.
yes.
And the other 2 are in French,
The other
course.
2 plays are in French or written in French, but one of them is an Acte sans parole by Samuel Beckett, and of course there are no words in an Acte
Samuel
sans parole.
Samuel is American, isn't it? No?
He's English.
He's English and
he's
was
Irish,
a French
really. He was okay. born in Dublin, and he spent a good part of his life in France, especially during the Second World War. And he wrote most of his work in French because he felt that stylistically his work was more pure when he wrote in French, and so...
And he knew the languages as well, right?
Yes. He okay. was, like our students, bilingual.
Okay, great.
The last play that I would like to tell you about is L'École des Veuves by Jean Cocteau, and that play is entirely in French. It was directed by Jean-Yves Roy, because unfortunately my French is not sufficiently elegant to... for me to direct in French.
Okay.
He's done a lovely job. Jean-Yves is a professor,
teacher.
A teacher
at the school.
In the secondary program at the school.
Okay.
And the play is set in a tomb in France,
yes.
one of the little family tombs. And a young widow is there with her nurse, and she has decided to spend her life, the rest of her life there, and to starve herself to death because her late husband has just been buried there, and she wants to prove to her friends what a good wife she is.
Okay, so
well, she gets very hungry,
Okay. And she also falls in love with a guard, and unfortunately,
she gives up on her.
She gives up. They take the coffin out of the tomb so they can all live happily ever after in the tomb together. And the poor husband in his coffin is out.
He's
in
gone.
The cold. It's very comic. It's a okay. lovely play.
Okay, and I guess you told me this play was the longest, 40 minutes.
Yes, it's between a half an hour and 40 minutes.
Okay, great. So the whole show would be an hour and a half, right?
About an hour and a half, so with one intermission.
Okay, well, thank you very much for letting us know about it.
Oh, and thank you.
This conclude this part. So I'll repeat, the play will be at the French American School location, which is on Buchanan Street, and you can see it right there. And if you need any information, just call the French American School. Thank you.